How's it going, guys? So in today's video, we're going to be doing a review that honestly I should have done several months ago. We're going to be reviewing this guy. This is the Atlas Adventure Pack. Atlas sent me this probably 4 months ago now, and I'm just now getting around to reviewing it. It does some things really, really well. It does some other really important things not so well, and we're going to talk about it in this video. Okay, so this is the Atlas Adventure 70 liter pack. As you can see, it's a large pack. It will hold an absolute ton of gear, and sometimes that's the downside to a big pack, is that you're tempted to fill it and it ends up incredibly heavy. First of all, let's talk about some of the things that I really like about this bag. Material-wise, it is very, very well made. It's got a lot of weather-resistant zippers. It's got a lot of this tear-resistant kind of stretchy material in the areas where you'd stuff a tripod or maybe a jacket. I really like the zipper pulls. Zipper pulls have these nice little finger hooks. All the zippers work really well. It's a front access pack, which means that the side that is against your back is the side that you open up to access all of your gear. So I've mentioned that it'll hold a ton of gear. This bag is really well designed for anybody that uses really long telephoto lenses, maybe a 500 f4 or something like that. And it has kind of a clever way of implementing that. It has this area here, which they call their origami system, where in this current configuration, it can be used to hold other stuff. Maybe it's coats, jackets, maybe you're backpacking with this thing and you're putting your tents and your other gear like that. Or you can push this in like this, and now it expands this section here for camera gear. So if you're packing long telephoto lenses, you can use it like this and just extend this foam padding section, and you can fill all of this with camera gear. It has lots of, oh, found a battery. That's nice. It really utilizes this full area here. You can stuff all kinds of lens cloths and things in here. Special compartments for wallets and keys. This top section here flips open, and then you have a duffel style top where you can access that area that uses the origami system to stuff your tent supplies or coats or whatever you're gonna be stuffing in there. It's got this big full access back area here with more pockets, more mesh pockets. I think you're getting the point. Just tons of storage, tons of pockets, and while that's a good thing, it's also a negative. If you've ever wore a coat with a whole bunch of pockets and then you go to find your keys, you go through every pocket before you eventually find your keys. And that's kind of one of the things that I've discovered when I was using this, is that it took me a long time to figure out where I put things. And I know that, like, the more you use a pack, the more you'll kind of get your system down and you'll, you know, you'll get better at knowing where stuff is. But when you have, you know, 20 pockets on a bag, the first 15 times you use the bag, you're gonna struggle to figure out which pocket you put what in. So while it's one of the strengths, it's also kind of one of the weaknesses. It's a personal preference thing. Another thing that they did really well with this bag, or is both a negative and a positive, is the waist belt. The waist straps are not only customizable, you can order a medium, large, or extra large. In my case, I have the extra large. But the waist pad, the waist belt is incredibly padded. It's very, very wide and beefy, which makes it very comfortable when wearing the waist belt. Shoulder straps, they're pretty thick, but they're also a little bit narrow, and one of my biggest critiques is going to be of these. And these are also adjustable, so you can get different lengths, and you can easily just undo the Velcro on top, slide it out. Waist belt is also removable. You can just undo the Velcro and pull the whole thing out in case you're somebody that likes to hike without the waist belt. Another thing that they've done that's pretty clever is that you can actually remove this aluminum frame. So you can reach in here, and let's say you're going to be flying with this guy, you can reach in here and remove this aluminum frame, which they also have a couple different sizes of. This is the medium. They also have a large, which are for people that are taller than, I believe, 5'10". This is a pretty clever thing, because if you're flying, you can take that out and now you can compress this down a little bit more and shorten the bag. That way the people at the gate don't glare at you when you try to take this as carry-on. Another thing that they've done that's a little different than other bags is that they have this kind of mesh breathable material here where it's actually got some slots and venting. That way when you're hiking with the pack, you're not supposed to sweat quite as much. I actually haven't had a chance to take this out in hot temperatures, so I don't know how that works, but I can definitely see how it could work pretty well. Also, on the hip waist belt, you have these pouches where you can either stuff, you know, water bottles, a lens, maybe it's some trash. It's got one on either side, another really cool thing. The tripod holding system is also pretty nice. It's got this stretchy material here. I do kind of worry that this might not be as rip resistant as I would like to see it, but I can definitely see that tripods will be nice and secured on here. It has a handle on the side so you can side carry it just like a suitcase, which is nice. It does a lot of things really, really well. But let's talk about some of the negatives, because I've had this for 4 months and I've probably only used it two or three times. The reason for it is I have another bag that I really like, and it takes quite a bit for me to switch from that. And I wanted to use this. I was really excited about it. But let me show you some of the things I don't like so much about it. The first thing I kind of mentioned a little bit, it's more of just like a small thing, but it's the fact that it has so many pockets, it's kind of difficult to remember where you put things. Also, another thing is about how it opens. So when you open this bag, the shoulder straps, the waist belt, everything flips over. And if you're shooting in mud or snow or anything less than ideal, your shoulder straps, your hip, your waist belt, it all just flops over into the mud or into the snow. It's not the biggest deal, but I would like to see the shoulder straps at the very least separate from this big flap. It just means that the shoulder straps are gonna get really messy and dirty every time you open the bag. But probably my biggest critique and the reason that I haven't found myself using it very much is the fact that I don't feel like it's comfortable. It doesn't fit my back very well. And to their credit, they've worked really hard, like kind of going back and forth with me, like making sure, like I've even sent them photos and videos of how I've got it set up, making sure that I've got stuff adjusted well. And they tried really, their customer service is awesome in that way, but even when I have it adjusted perfectly, it's just not very comfortable on my back. It doesn't sit well against my back. It kind of has this big pad where the hip belt goes through, and that pushes really hard against your lower back, and then I feel like the rest of the back doesn't really touch my back enough. Also, I feel like these shoulder straps are too narrow. They seem very, very narrow, and they kind of pinch my neck. Granted, I have a big, thick neck, but they're too narrow. I would like to see these kind of, you know, open up to the sides. That way it allows a little bit more room for your neck. I'd also like to see a little bit softer and wider material for these straps. And I want to say this, it's so relative to the person wearing it. Like what one person feels is comfortable, another person might feel is not comfortable. I personally just don't find this bag comfortable, and that's a big deal for a big bag. Big bags above all other bags need to be comfortable because you're putting a lot of gear in them. This is a 70 liter bag designed to hold a whole bunch of gear. And if you're putting a whole bunch of gear into a kind of a not so comfortable bag, it's kind of a problem. I definitely want to preface this by saying that this could be a totally subjective thing. Maybe Nick, you know, a guy that doesn't have a frame like everybody else thinks it's uncomfortable, maybe you would. So I highly recommend that you actually try it on before you buy, if you can do that. Another thing that I don't really care for is the fact that because it is a big bag, it starts off pretty heavy. I believe this comes in at about 6.7 pounds. That's completely empty. And granted, you don't have to add any kind of ICU to it, which is definitely a positive. The fact that you don't have to put an ICU in it means that you know, price tag that's coming in right there, you have everything that you need at that point, which is nice. You don't have to buy accessories and ICUs separately. But when you're starting with a bag that's starting off heavy and then you put a whole bunch of gear in, it makes for a heavy pack. So keep that in mind. This is not gonna be for the person that, you know, has a small setup. If you're a person with three lenses and one camera, You don't need this. And if you're someone that is backpacking a lot, you might be better off to just start with a backpacking bag and then throw an ICU from S-Stop or Shimoda or something in it. But I feel like this would be great for the person that needs a bag to hold large telephoto lenses. It's going to hold that stuff really well. But I definitely recommend trying it on before you buy it, because I found it to not be super comfortable. And for that reason, it's kind of just sat on the shelf for a long time. So because it's been sitting on the shelf for a long time, let's give this bag away. So if you want to win this bag, all you have to do is leave a comment down below. Let me know what bag you have and why you want this one. Make sure that you follow both Atlas Packs and myself on Instagram. Let's say the end of August, we'll give this pack away and I'll ship it to you free of cost. So we'll figure that out. It doesn't need to be just sitting on my shelf. It's too good of looking a bag. That's something I didn't really talk about, is I love the looks of this bag. I think this is one of the best looking bags that I've seen in a long time. Just wish it was a little bit more comfortable. All right, thank you guys so much for watching. You can check these guys out. This is, again, the Atlas Adventure Pack. They also have a smaller bag called the Athlete. And hopefully this has been interesting to you guys. Take it easy, and we'll see you in the next video. Bye-bye.